In this tutorial, we will learn how to download both R and RStudio programs. If you'd like to work in RStudio, which is a much more user-friendly environment for working with R code and script, you'll need to download both R and RStudio programs. And so to do so, let's just go to google.com and into our search engine here. Into our search engine field, let's type in RCRAN. And the CRAN stands for Comprehensive R Archive Network here. And this will just take us to the official, the Comprehensive R Archive Network, or CRAN. It takes us to the official website here, which is just cran.r/r-project.org. Okay. And so it doesn't look too flashy, but this is where you're going to download and install what we would call base R. And so again, you need base R already downloaded in order to then use RStudio, which you'll also need to download. And you can see you can download R for Linux or for Mac operating systems or for Windows operating systems here as well. And so let's start with Windows and then I'll show you Mac operating systems. So if you click on download R here for Windows, you'll likely be installing R for the first time. And so you just click on this link here. And then you would download the most recent version of R for Windows, which in this case is R version 3.5.1. And this changes fairly quickly as a number of different versions of R and improvements come into being. Okay, so now let's go back and let's take a look at what you'll need to do if you download R for Mac operating system. So you can click here on this link. And you'll notice that you have some other options here, okay? And it also gives you some information about which versions of the Mac operating system are no longer supported for R. And so you might have to download a much older version of R if you have a very old operating system. And if that's the case, then you'll likely run into other problems with certain packages you might download as well for R that won't necessarily work with the older versions of the R platform. And so here you can see that we have the latest release. So this is R3.5.1 here. And so if you click on this, you could then save this and download. And this is how you can actually download the download the files for your Mac operating system. Okay. Now, the other thing I want to point out here is that if you look down further, you can see legacy operating systems, OS X systems specifically, and if you need to download older versions, such as for the Snow Leopard version of the Mac operating system, you can do it here. Okay. Ideally, you're able to download the most up-to-date version of the R package or of the R program here. Okay. So just click here and install. All right. Now going back, if you're a Linux user, you would just click here. And hopefully you know what to do with this. I'm assuming that if you are a Linux user that you probably have, you're fairly adept at working with your computer and you'll understand how to actually download these files for the Linux operating system. Okay, so that is how you would download, or at least start the download process for the R or the base R program. But what about if you want to do it now, if you're ready to install RStudio? Remember, R and RStudio are two separate programs, and we need R in order for RStudio to run. RStudio sits on top of R. And so to do so, let's just go up into our browser window here and just do a simple search. So let's do RStudio, just type that in. And so probably your first hit is going to be the official RStudio website, which is just www.rstudio.com here. You can click on this link here. And when you come to this website, you'll see that you have, this is a little bit more of a shiny or flashy looking web page here than what we saw with the base R program that's hosted on the CRAN network. And so what we're interested in downloading here is RStudio. Okay, so let's click on RStudio here, or rather download here at the bottom. And what you'll see is that you have different options. For our purposes, we're going to use RStudio Desktop, which is an open source license here. Okay, so for RStudio Desktop, just click this download here. Now, If you wanted a commercial license for your organization, then it's going to be $995 a year, and you'd buy this here, and you can buy the RStudio desktop. You can also gain access to the RStudio server too as an open source license for free if that's something that you'd like to do. Or again, if you're working within an organization, you might want to download the or to subscribe to the commercial license, which is about $10,000 a year. And these are going to be for if this is something you systematically want to implement in your organization and you want some additional functionalities such as project sharing, enterprise security, and things like that, as well as if you want to, if you do want to use the server version, even in the free version, you can access RStudio via a web browser as opposed to operating it from your desktop. Okay, so again, for our purposes, you're going to download RStudio here, which is the desktop open source license, the free version, so please don't pay anything for it for our purposes. Okay, and now what you'll see is that you can download different versions for different operating systems you might be working with. So Linux users here, and we have the Ubuntu platforms and so forth. But if you're a Windows user or a Mac user, which is probably what most of you are using, here you'll see that we have Windows Vista 7, 8, and 10 operating systems are supported for RStudio. So you can click here to start that download process. Or if you are a Mac user, we can see that Mac operating system OS X 10.6 and more recent 64-bit is going to be supported here as well. So you can click on either one of those. And so once you click on these, you can start the download process here. Okay, and then you would just save it, the execution file, and then start the download and the install after that. Okay, so that's how you download RStudio. And so in this tutorial, I showed you how to download both R and RStudio. Again, you need to download base R if you'd like to use RStudio. Hope that helped.